Arthur Davis,
Yeah.
Sikopo, welcome to Africa 54.
Thank you so much, Paul, for having me on this particular platform.
How are things in Zambia? I know the lockdown has been relaxed a little bit, but how has the lockdown impacted you as a person, businesses, and a lot of people in Zambia?
My work involves moving around. My work involves meeting people around. So during this partial lockdown, or when we had so much, you know, restrictions in terms of movement, in terms of how you conduct yourselves, my work has sort of been impacted to the negative. As a journalist, you always get information through interacting. You know, you always get information through meeting different people. So it has been a little bit of a challenge because I have not been able to, you know, move around and do my work, you know, as I used to do it. And in terms of, you know, businesses around, most businesses have been impacted, you know, negatively because they can't trade as they used to do. They are always, the numbers of people that are going out there to, you know, to go and buy or to go and trade are very few because everyone is, has been trying to stay indoors.
How is the journalistic community, or you as a journalist in that country, really trying to tell that story? How are you covering COVID?
We are covering COVID from, I would say, two angles. So the one aspect is, you know, where you get these statistics from the health experts, you know, from the Minister of Health and others in charge of giving out information. Then we disseminate that. Then the other angle is, you know, where I'm talking about, you know, the need for us journalists, you know, to up our game in terms of putting that human face on to COVID. You know, let's just not do stories, you know, 500 people have been have tested positive to COVID-19, but we are also doing stories to say, okay, among those 500, there are five doctors. But what does this mean in terms of the health sector? We have five doctors that have been, you know, removed from their workstations into isolation facilities. How is this affecting, you know, the health sector? And I've seen quite a number of journalists, you know, doing such stories, which is very commendable. You know, I've seen journalists, you know, focusing on issues to do with, you know, sexual reproductive health and rights, SRHR, which is, you know, has been, you know, left out or forgotten. So I've seen journalists doing such stories, which is very commendable, which even ask the government or reminds government to say, even if we're fighting COVID-19 this side, let us not forget other key issues that we need to fight, such as, you know, HIV and AIDS, you know, such as the provision of sanitary towels, you know, to girls in schools. So I've seen a number of journalists, you know, doing those particular stories, which are quite encouraging and quite positive. And I must say that I think that the Zambian journalists are doing everything they can, you know, to report about COVID-19. But of course, we could do more.
You talked about social distancing. You come from a country. I've been there about three times, and I've crisscrossed the country. People like to party. Zambians like to hang out. They like to be with friends. They like to drink that beer. When you talk about social distancing, how is that applicable in a country where you are?
Well, of course, Zambians like their drink. Yeah, it is applicable in most places. Social distancing is being observed, but not everywhere. But there are certain places where you just can't get social distance. A popular trading area around Lusaka, which is called Soweto Market.
I've been
when
there.
When you go that side,
yes.
You've been there.
Yes.
When you go that side, you think you are in another world. That, you know, you think that COVID-19 doesn't exist. But when you move from that particular side to, you know, other places or other shopping malls, you'd of course see that social distancing.
Well, Arthur Davis, thank you so much for your insight.
Thank you so much, Paul.